Happy New Year, everyone. Let's have a look at 10 80s sitcoms you definitely forgot about approximately 70% of, but maybe more because everyone watched different things and lived in different ITV areas, and maybe they hadn't put 50p in their Rumbelows TV that week, so they missed it. And even I can't find out a lot about these other than what it said in the papers at the time, so bear with me if you think some of the info is a bit astray, although that's not as catchy a title as Top 10 80s British Sitcoms You Probably Forgot About. Number 1, Fawlty Towers. I'm joking. It's The Refuge. Channel 4, 1987 to 1988. This 80s British sitcom starred Julia Hills, Lou Wakefield, Caroline Blakiston, Carol Heyman, who co-wrote this with Sue Townsend, and Louise Mahoney. It's set in a women's refuge with a strictly no-men policy, although it's not a state-run establishment. It's the home of a local radio interviewer, Dee Dee, who offers an open house on air one day and ends up taking in more people than she had in mind.
It's a refuge.
No, they're for the benefit tonight.
I'm bloody starving!
They distract me. Fantastically expensive watered-down booze. One is forced to sit at a tiny, cramped table which is illuminated by dim red light. And then when one orders food, it's overpriced, badly cooked, and hopelessly inadequate for one's needs. Julia, let go! Oh, I've got so much to do.
So have I. Got to practice my mistress of ceremony duties.
Number 2, Father's Day, Channel 4, 1983 to 1984, starring John Alderton, Rosalind Ayers, Karen Archer, Dominique Burns, and Kate Alderton, John's daughter, and also Zach Nicholson and Paul Angelis. I can't even find any footage of this one, but real-life daughter Kate plays on-screen daughter Tasha. John's character is a writer, because that's nice and relatable to us all, isn't it? A writer who works from home and he's fighting for some control over his life whilst being dominated by his wife and children. You have to wonder what the partners of the writers of these sitcoms think whenever they see the latest idea that they've had. Number 3, Don't Rock the Boat, ITV, 1982 to 1983. Older man Jack Hoxton, played by Nigel Davenport, decides it's time for his sons to meet his new lady friend, Dixie, played by Sheila White. The two lads, Les and Billy, played by John Price and David Jansen respectively, are imagining a middle-aged lady to walk through the door.
Now ask yourself, what sort of woman would appeal to a mature man? I'll tell you, a nice, mature, middle-aged lady.
Hello, lads. Meet Dixie.
Yeah, I saw him in a show. I liked his legs, and I went backstage and asked if he'd like to come out for a drink.
Any strippers in your show?
No, it's a family audience. If we get one.
Of course, he was a married man once, you know.
I should hope so, for your sake.
You're pretty quick on your feet, aren't you?
If you went on the road with the Les Lester Lovelies when you were 16, you'd be quick on your feet.
Number 4, Hillary, starring Marty Caine, 1984 to 1986. No footage of this one either, I'm afraid, but that's what it's like sometimes when you're doing these lists. I often miss out some really obscure ones that would get you because I can't find the clips, but I think I'll put them all together in one video at some stage to really test your memories. But this was Hillary, and it was BBC Two. Marty plays a researcher on a TV chat show. She's divorced, and she lives with a minor bird named Arthur. If you're a fan of our Marty, then please have a look at my tribute to Marty Caine video. There's a link in the description. Number 5, The Magnificent Evans, BBC One, 1984. Ronnie Barker trots out another one of his accents in this incredibly short-lived series about a Welsh photographer named Plantagenet Evans and his fiancée Rachel, played by Sharon Morgan.
Morning.
Oh. That.
Just the greeting of a lover for his lass. Makes you cough. I should think I would be a poor lover if I couldn't make you cough.
He hasn't got the hang of much yet.
No, but he's improving. He's improving. When he first came here, he was absolutely useless. Now, he is merely incompetent. Listen, I can't go leaping into matrimony. The artist belongs to the whole community. You came to me with no qualifications whatsoever, except a very natural gift for looking well in black stockings.
Number six, Young at Heart, ITV 1980 to 1982. Starring John Mills and Megs Jenkins, this was about Albert and Ethel Collier dealing with the sudden enforced retirement of Albert from his job as a pottery worker. Their retirement plans are of the unlucky Alf variety, however, because whatever they set out to do on any given day, it seems to become an absolute palaver.
I'm proud of you. I bet she was surprised, wasn't she?
She was.
Aye. Do you know something? This could be the turning point of your marriage.
It could. Barbara told me not to bother coming home.
7. The Management, 1988, Channel 4. I, of course, remember Hale and Pierce's management characters from their sketch show and those Clarettes adverts. Do you remember Clarettes? But I had no idea they had a sitcom out of it as well. It looks like I didn't miss much, to be honest.
Off to Bournemouth, follow Mr. Spook, Bournemouth. Oh, off to Bournemouth.
Well, how do I look?
You're going to a funeral?
Wedding, actually. And I was rather hoping we could hold the reception here.
Oh, we'd be flattered to organise the reception.
Of your cash.
In advance.
In news notes.
Hello, Dennis. It's me. Yeah, first things first, nice piece yesterday. I slept with porpoise, says cabinet minister's wife.
Piers isn't eating. So? Well, you know, first sign of love.
Really?
Yeah, I can't get him out of my system.
Number 8, Big Jim and the Figaro Club, 1979 to 1981, BBC Two. The voice of Portland Bill, aka Norman Rossington, starred in this one as Big Jim. The Figaro Club is a bunch of friends who are builders in a small coastal town. The show is set in the 50s. The club has its own special code language that they all use, and despite being handy tradies, the lads try to avoid working wherever possible.
Snot goblin little Caesar. He wants tar and feather in.
Steady on, Ned. What's up?
All this.
Oh, what, Ned?
Me old homestead, me spread, me hacienda.
Of course, stands to reason. There always has to be as many gaffers as blokes to do the work. Wouldn't mind betting on Noah's Ark. The poor mush came round with a bucket and shovel behind the elephants. Had some jumped up little Noel telling him how it ought to be done.
Time for din-dins, kiddywinks.
Strangle him with his own gullies. Oh, swing for that snout. Let me at him. Oh, no, I can't buy your time.
Cheers, Harry. Anyway, heard him going on about what they done to you, Ned. Alderman bloody Potts. I don't know what this town's coming to. A useless article like that for mayor.
Number 9, The Labours of Erica, 1989 to 1990, ITV. This sitcom starred Brenda Blethyn as Erica Parsons, who finds a list that she had written as a young girl that details all the things she wanted to do before turning 18. She quickly realises that she hasn't done any of them, and so sets out to tick them all off the list by the time of her 40th birthday.
Hello? Oh, just a moment, please. It's your wife. So you didn't go after all? And you're downstairs? Oh, good. No, I shouldn't bother coming up. Mrs. Rook, why don't I pop down? No, actually, I've been looking in my diary.
The list of 12 things.
I realised I hadn't done any of them. No mountains climbed, no poetry published. Not even a policeman's helmet.
And number 10, That's Love, 1988 to 1992, ITV. Jimmy Mulville and Diana Hardcastle play a young couple, Patsy and Donald, who are married, but still on the journey of finding out about each other's pasts. Gradually, however, it comes to light that the two actually never got married due to some sort of technicality, and so they do the ceremony again, for real this time. Trouble is, Donald then starts an affair with his client, played by Lisa Goddard, and Patsy has an affair with the inevitable marriage counsellor Tristan, played by Tony Slattery.
Just bought my designs for the interior of his new mini tourer.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Yes, for thousands, if it sells.
Right. Serious faces for serious income.
Ooh, Turkish delight. How lovely. Hello, Amanda. How are you?
Fine. Great.
Good.
This must be Gary.
I'm afraid so.
Hi. Well. So, you lied?
Yes. I lied.
I can't believe it.
Well, there you are.
And there you have it. Happy New Year, everybody. Let me know if there's any more long-lost sitcoms you think I should be adding to my lists. And don't forget, if you want to look at that Marty Caine video, the link is in the description. And my top tip for 2023, don't marry a sitcom writer. They're obsessed with affairs. Bye for now.